Adding sign-in with Apple to Firebase authentication in a SwiftUI project is unnecessarily complex due to the fragmented setup process requiring developers to juggle multiple configurations across Apple Developer Portal, Firebase Console, and Xcode. The lack of clear end-to-end documentation means you often run into vague errors, mismatched tokens, or missing entitlements. This video is the definitive guide to making it work, walking you through every step from setting up credentials to handling authentication in SwiftUI, ensuring you don't waste hours debugging. Make sure to check out the link in the description for my special sale. Today, we are going to talk about sign-in with Apple with Firebase. We are going to talk about signing in, you know, the button, signing out with Apple and Firebase, and most importantly, deleting your account. There is little to no information about this out there, so this will be your comprehensive guide of how to use Firebase authentication with sign in with Apple. This is going to be a two-part series, so make sure to check out the link in the description for the second part. Today, we are going to set up everything to make sure that the code will work. We're going to talk about the Xcode project, the code, in the second tutorial. Okay, so here we are. We are at firebase.google.com. Let's go to our console and let's create our first project. Well, we are going to tap on create a project. And what I have done is just started a brand new Xcode project. It's called Firebase Sign-In with Apple Demo. Okay, what I'm going to do is just grab the bundle identifier, go to signing in capabilities, grab that bundle identifier, and I'm going to paste it right over here. Of course, I'm going to remove the pre-part, and we are going to have Firebase sign-in with Apple demo. Let's continue. I'm just going to disable Gemini for Firebase. We don't need that in our case, and also disable Google Analytics. This is just a simple tutorial for signing in with Apple. Now, while this is going to load, I'm going to come back over here to our project, and I'm going to go, we are already here, to signing in capabilities, and add a new capability, sign in with Apple. Okay, this is going to add the sign in with Apple capability, and also, most importantly, it's going to communicate with the App Store Connect to store my bundle identifier, so I will be able to use it. I'm using automatically managed signing to do all of this. Otherwise, you would need to create your bundle identifier in the Apple Developer Portal. It's a nightmare to do that manually. So yeah, make sure that you selected automatically managed signings. You selected your team. Of course, you need to have a paid subscription for Apple, and the sign in with Apple is added. Okay, let's go back to our browser. Firebase, your Firebase project is ready. Let's click on continue. And what we are going to do is create an iOS app. You know, I still have that bundle identifier in my clipboard, so I'm going to copy and paste it over there. Let's register our app. And next, we are going to download the config file. Let's do that. Download Google Service Info plist file. And let's go to Xcode and drag and drop it in. Make sure that it is on the root folder or of your system, and copy files to destination. Let's finish. And if you are using a lot of Google Service Info playlist files, then you are going to get appended that number. Just remove it like so. And again, it's on the root folder right over here. Okay, let's go back. Let's click on next. And yeah, we are going to add the Firebase iOS SDK later on. Let's click on next again. We are going to initialize this. Make sure to check out the link in the description for the second video where we are going to do all of this coding part in Xcode. Let's continue to console. And next up, we want to set up Cloud Firestore. Now, why do we want to do that? Because we are talking about authentication, right? Well, once you authenticate, you are going to be created a user, but that user should be linked to your Cloud Firestore database. Therefore, we are going to also create a profile for that user. We need to create a Cloud Firestore project, not the project, a database for it. So let's just click on there, Firestore database. Let's create our database. Default database, yes. Location, select your location. This depends on where you think your most of your users are located. This is just fine for our case. And let's start in test mode. Again, you might want to change this later on for your own project. Currently, it's just going to allow read and write access to our database for 30 days from today. Okay, it's setting up security rules, and there we go. We have our Firestore database. iOS developers, this is your chance. I'm running a sale where you get all my SwiftUI products bundled together for a massive 91% off. And that's not all. SwiftUI Camp is included. This four-week live bootcamp on Zoom will take you from coder to SwiftUI expert, starting March the 3rd. The total value, $2,081, but for a limited time, it's yours for only $199. Don't miss out on this insane deal. Grab it now. The link is in the description. Next up, let's create our authentication. So again, we want to get started right over here. So I want to click on that. And we have a few options. Native provides additional providers. This is what we are going to do. Let's create an Apple sign-in with Apple provider. So what you want to do is just enable this. And I'm going to save this right now, but we are going to also complete all of this stuff, what you can see right over here. All of this stuff we are going to use. So let's save, so you know it is enabled. And now let's go into our developer portal, Apple developer portal, and let's grab all of this information. So again, I'm going to go in here, so I will edit it. So we need the services ID, and then we want to configure our OAuth code flow, and also use this authorization URL, you know, just to link everything up with our App Store Connect account. So what we want to do is just go to developer.apple.com, select account, of course, log in if you haven't already done so. Okay, and now let's just go to identifiers under certificates, IDs, and profiles. Let's just select that. And then, yeah, you know, you have all of your identifiers right over here. We might want to search for our identifier, so we make sure that it's over there. Yes, there it is. But we don't care about the Apple IDs, the app IDs. We want to create a service ID. Remember, we need it right over here. Service ID. Okay, so for that, we want to click on the plus button right over here under identifiers. Select service IDs. Click on continue and give it a description. Well, I'm just going to name it as my project, okay? And then the identifier. You should use a reverse domain name style string, and I'm just going to use my bundle identifier and append dot sign in with Apple, so S-I-W-A. Let's click on continue. And next, of course, you want to check that everything is okay for the description and identifier, and then register over there. Okay, we have it right over here. And next up, we want to configure it. So click on it and then select sign in with Apple. Okay, click on the configure button. And there we go. Next, we want to select our primary app ID. So search for that. I'm just going to paste it in. Yes, there we go. Now, domains and subdomains and return URLs. Let's go back to our Firebase console and scroll all the way down and copy this link out and paste it under return URLs. Okay, that's fine. Next up, you want to set up your domains and subdomains. So copy out only this part. So again, take a look at it. You want to copy only that part out and paste it in there. Okay, let's click on next. And let's check primary bundle and website URLs. yes, everything seems to be okay. Let's click on done and then continue and check everything that's okay. Let's click on save. There we go. So now our service ID is set up. Great. Next, we want to create a key. So let's go under keys right over here. Click on the plus button and then key name. Yeah, I'm just going to use, well, yeah. Let's just copy out our bundle identifier again. There we go. Copy that out. Let's go back to Safari. And the key name, let's just name it like so. Okay. Key usage description, that's optional. What you want to do is check sign in with Apple right over here. Next, click on configure. We need to configure it. Let's select our primary bundle, primary app ID. Again, I'm just pasting the bundle ID in there. Okay, let's click on save and then continue. And there we go. We have set it up. Now it's time to register it. This is really important, the next step. You want to download this key, but you also want to store it in a safe place. So make sure that you are storing it in a safe place and, of course, not adding this to your GitHub repository. Okay, let's click on download. And as you can see, after that, we can't do anything. We can't download it again. What I'm going to do is just open it up. Let's just see. Downloads. And there we go. Let's open it with TextEdit. There we go. Let me just move this a little bit in. Okay, so this is your a private key that you have created. What you want to do is just copy all of its content. So hit Command A and then Command C to copy everything out. And then go right over here in your Firebase console and paste it in. Now we need to set up the Apple Team ID and the key ID. Okay, let's go back to our certificates, identifiers, and profiles and copy out the key ID. There we go. And paste it in there. By the way, the key ID is also located in the name of your file. And then Apple Team ID. Your Apple Team ID can be found right over here, all the way up, or you can find it in your developer portal account. So I'm just going to copy this out and then paste it right over there. So everything seems to be okay. Now, let's see what's going on. Oh, we forgot one final thing. As you can see, the save button is still disabled. We want to set up the services ID. So the services ID is our bundle identifier. Basically, let's just go back. The services ID, let's go to identifiers and select services IDs. And it's this one. So with the appended SIWA. So I'm going to copy that out and paste it in there. Okay, now everything should be okay. The save button is right over here. Let's click on save. Really, really nice. So that's all you have to do to set up your Firebase dashboard, your sign-in provider with Apple. And of course, everything is set up inside your developer portal. We still have a few more minutes, so I'm going to go to my Xcode project and I'm going to talk you through what we are going to do next time. We are going to have an authentication system, and for that, we are going to need a new auth view. So let's continue and create our auth view. There we go. And also, we are going to have that authentication system inside a main view. So let's click on new file from template, Swift UI view. Let's call this main view. Let's click on create right over there. And basically, that's it. We are going to do the authentication part in the main view. And if we are authenticated, then we are going to present our content view. If we are not, we are going to present the auth view so we can authenticate. And that's it. That's how easy it is to set up sign in with Apple, with Firebase. Make sure to check out the link in the description for my special sale.